Okay, so now let's first of all add this in my here in the index.ts so we don't get that error again. We're gonna say slash dashboard slash my recipes. Yeah, and then the element is going to be my recipes. What am I typing? My recipes. Okay, I've not exported it in the index too. Let me quickly go do that. So here. Okay, my recipes. Yeah. Now I can go back to the fuzzy card. Can go back here now. See my recipes. And then I won't get that 404 anymore. So now let's go build this my recipes component. So let's go back to pages, dashboard, my recipes. Now, my recipes is just like the home page. The only difference is that this time around, we are going to search using the user ID. That's all. So if you remember in our login, when a user logged in, we stored their ID. So that is what we are just going to use to search now. Instead of searching everything in the database for the recipes, we are just searching using the my recipes. So we are going to have similar thing. I can just go to the home page and copy some of those things. So instead of wasting our time here, I'm just going to go here, copy this. I think they are the same thing. Even the searching is the same thing. So I can just, just copy all this. It's just like a copy. Very small thing is going to change. So I'm going to copy this. I'll paste it like this. And I need to actually import all this. Let me just copy everything from the home page that was imported to. We'll remove what we don't need. So now I'll paste it. Yeah, let's go back to the home page and let's also copy even this return, because I believe everything is just the same. It's just a very little thing that's going to change for this my recipes. So you can actually just build it yourself. You don't have to watch me do it. Yeah, so the only thing I'm going to do now is that I now need to use the user ID. That's all. That's the only thing I need to change, just the user ID. So I'm just going to go back here, and instead of saying slash recipes, we simply fetch all the recipe. I'm going to pass a template string. I'm going to say this is going to now going to go to slash recipe slash user, and then we get the user ID from session storage that we stored it there, and then we pass that in. So with this now, whenever we load this page, we know that we are going to fetch only the things that belongs to this particular user. That's all we are going to do there. Yeah, and then the same thing is suspense true. Every other thing, like I said, is true. I'm going to remove this comment. Don't need to be in both of them. Every other thing is just the same thing. So one thing I want to take a look at I think it works fine. Even our search, if you go back to our search, where is the hook? Our search hook. If you go to the search hook here, if you click on it, you will notice that we are taking in the query and we are searching to find anywhere we can see this. Now, one thing we could modify from what I noticed that is that when we are searching, we don't take cognizance of who created these things. So, two ways to solve it is to go back to our server and then create an endpoint that we will call when we are on our page to search. The other way we can solve it is to simply remove searching ability from my recipes. So right now, if I go to my recipe, it should work now because there's nothing to do there. So if I go to my recipes, if I click on it, now this is my recipe, the one I created. Now, very easy. So if I go back to homes, I find the one everybody created. If I see testing here, if I go back to my recipes, now if I search for testing, which I found in somebody else's, so if I search it, now it found it, but it's not me that created it. So there are two ways we can solve this problem. Go back and create another endpoint, or make our endpoint to assert the user. So if we pass a user, it searches by the user. If not, it doesn't search by the user. So like I mentioned, you can solve this problem. It can be a bonus for you. So you solve this problem, probably go back to the backend, implement the feature. But the easiest thing to do is just remove the searching. But for me, I think I will just leave it. I'll just leave this part. But you can clone the repo and, do a lot of things. Like I said earlier in this video, there's so many things that you can do. There's so many improvements. You can add pagination to this application. There's so many things you can do. So, but with this now, I believe we have been able to implement that. So if I go here initially, I see all my recipes, but it's all the searching that makes me to be able to search even the things that I didn't create myself. So, well, easiest thing, I will just remove this search functionality from here, but I don't want to do that. I'm just going to leave room for it. You go implement that feature yourself. Yeah. So the next thing we need to do now is the view more. So when a user click on view more, we want to send the user somewhere. So where do we want to send the user? Let's take a look at our code. Let's take a look at the dashboard layout. Let's see something. Okay, we don't have any of that available right now. I thought we had that. So let's quickly go back. So let's go back and go to the pages. Let's create, go to the pages like dashboard. And right in the dashboard, let's create another file. Let's call it more. Just, you know, more. More.tsx. We're going to say expert const more is equals to, and for now we're going to return null. No. And let's go to app.tsx and let's add that. I'm going to say path is slash dashboard slash recipe slash the recipe ID. So we're going to pass that. And what element do we want to render? Element. We want to render the. Okay, I need to also import the more in the index for dashboard. So I'm going to say more. Yeah. Then we say we are rendering the more. The more. No. Okay, we need to import that. So let's say. Yeah. All right. So now when you click on view more, we now get to see this. Okay, so let's go work on the view more parts. Let's go to the page. Where is it? Here. Let's go. Now this page is just very, very simple, you know. We just want to show everything. So we're going to use our cat component here. So right now I'm getting the params, which is the ID. You remember when I made that mistake earlier instead of use location? So this is use params and it's going to return the ID to me, because remember in my app.tx I called it, I go down here, I called it ID. So I now say, where is that? Oh, I think, let me just click here. And I say, use params.id. Then I call the fetcher function again. I don't think I need to explain this over and over again. And what are we doing here? We are just getting slash recipe slash params. So the recipe ID, we are getting a single recipe. If we have an error, just like we did before, we throw the error and then we return null. Let's now work on these parts. If we don't have an error, let's present the data. So now, if you don't have an error, we're going to call suspense. Remember, we have to now call suspense because we enabled suspense through here, which is now how we fetch our data. And we are using SWR here to fetch the data for us. So we are saying that a div, we give it a div with class name of flex, direction of like flex, display flex, align item center, justify content center, and margin is auto. Then we display our cat. At this point now, we are using that is full prop that we passed, that we created earlier. We're saying that is full is true. So all those props that we set when it is true, they are all going to be set at this point. And we're passing an ID, and we're passing a title, we're passing the image, we're passing the ingredients, we're passing the notes, if there is a note, we're passing the description, we're passing the email, and like remember, we are just using avatar from Unsplash. We are just using image from Unsplash. You can also implement this feature whereby the user is able to upload an avatar. And then with this now, we have our view more components ready to go. Nothing else to do. So, you know, very, very easy. We have done all the hard work. So let us go back and take a look. If I click on view more now, I have an error. So it says slash dashboard slash recipe. Okay, since I wrote slash recipes, it's correct now. It's correct. Slash dashboard slash recipe slash ID. So why is this not picking up what I have? It's trying. Let me see what error is there. It's trying this error here. This first error. It's not even throwing the error from this place. So why is that? Let me refresh one more time. Is my server down? So let me check the server. Seems like the server is down actually. Let's. Why so? Why is down? Well, let's say yarn dev. I don't know. I don't know when I terminate dev, I terminate. I don't know. I can't tell. Okay, let's go take a look. Let's refresh. I hope you don't have to log in. Yeah, so it works now. It works now. I think my server was down before. So you now have the image. This is view more. You have the title, the ingredients, the description. You know, I wrote just trash earlier. So if I go back to host now, I see everything. Let me click on this person's own. Click on view more. And now I have, I think, this person, this is not good. So I have testing is the name of, this was what we did in our backend. Testing. We have our OS, Linux, Windows, Node help, blah, blah, blah. You know. So our view more is working. And I think every other thing is working for this application. If you click on logout, we are logging out. Let me click on logout. And we log out. One thing we want to do is that, let me log in back and show you. TST. And then. So I'm logging in now. I'm logged in. Now, what I want to show you is that, even though I'm logged in, if I were to remove this and go back to the home page, I'm still able to access the home page. So I want to go and set like a security around this. If we are logged in, we don't want you to be able to access the home page, the login page. And if you are not logged in, we already did that, you can access that. So let's just do it the same thing for this one too. Okay, so let's go to the home page, not the home page, the landing page. Let's go to the landing page. And all we need to do is just to add a simple checker. Immediately you load the page, we are going to call use layout effect. I'm going to say use layout effect. I'm going to import the navigate, use navigate. Yeah. I'm just using the same thing that we have from from the dashboard layout. So I import use navigate from what's it called again? React Router DOM. I like to put all my packages above my undefined files. And then what we are simply doing is, if you do have a token and you do have an email, please go back to the dashboard. Please don't come back here. Remember in the dashboard part, we are checking if you don't have, and we send you back to the homepage. Now, if you have, you can come here. So with this being said now, if I log in, it already sent me back. Oh, well, okay, let me log out. Now let me try to go to the dashboard. Dashboard. It's sending me back to the homepage. Now let me log in and try to go to the home page now. Okay, let's see. So I'm logged in. Let me clean it now and try to go to the home page again. And boom, it refuses to go. So that is that. Now, one other thing we need to finish off is just the error page. Let's create an error page. Let's go back here. Let's go to the dashboard. No, this is not going to be in dashboard. Let's go to the pages and let's create a folder called error. Now let's go inside this error. We only have a single file there, so I'm just going to say index.tsx. If we have more than one file, maybe different, you want to create different errors or different, activities, then you just create them inside this error folder. So what am I going to have here? It's simple. So right here, I'm exporting use route error and use navigate from React Router DOM. So React Router DOM provides a hook called use route error, and then I'm calling this export const error page. Then this is just my initializing of navigate, and I'm checking if we have any error at all. I log the error to the console, and then this is just a function that is going to send you back to the home page. If you click on it, send you back to the home page. So what are we doing? We have our general classes here. I don't want to waste our time explaining tailwind classes anymore. But we simply have a button here, and now what the button does is simply tell you click to reload. So if you click on this button, it's sending you to the homepage. And that's what it simply does. Maybe we should change that to click to go back to home, because that's what actually does. If you click on it, you are going back to home. Now this here is the error itself. So if you open this up, when an error occurs, React Router DOM is going to show this error. But what I've seen in this error is that it's not something I want to show to my user. So I want to take a look at it myself. So if that error is occurring, well, now I'm just log into the console, take a look at it, and see what's going on. So it's not something I want to show to my user. So with this now, we have our error components, and then we can go back to our app.tsx. And instead of this error, whatever here, we can now see error page. And when we have an error, the error page is going to come up. Yeah, and with this now, we are done with the whole application that we set out to build. So, and everything is working fine, like we have tested. So all I have to say is thank you for staying with me. Thank you for joining me to the end of this project. Don't mind what we have here. Please add something interesting. I might delete it, or I might later add something that is good, so that when you take a look at it, you see something nice. Please share the video, likes, comments. Tell me what you think. Tell me what you feel about the video. Tell me the kind of video you want me to make next. What concept you want me to cover. And I'll be right there in the comment section, and I'll be reading it all, and then you will see the results. Yeah. So, like I said, just extend these functionalities for this application and make it yours. And one other thing I keep saying, please subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed. My metrics shows me that about 86% of people that watch my videos have not subscribed. So please subscribe, hit the notification bell, and let's keep this rolling. I will be seeing you in the next one.